how to eat
so
on TV.
So they pay me to do this.
Oh, that's good.
Just so get in there.
Brian Quinn's joining us, chefbq.com. You can actually come into your home and do cooking classes. Take over while I'm chewing, Brian. But sliders is what you're doing today.
We all love appetizers, right? I love going to some place and trying a lot of different things. In the summertime, I tend to look now and I go, am I going to commit to the quarter pound sausage or am I going to commit to the burger? If I break those burgers up into little sliders and then stuff them with different condiments, like you're having the blue cheese and bacon
slider. Well, I can taste the blue cheese, which I love. And you just mixed it
into the ground beef.
And let me ask you a question.
Yes, sir.
So I like crispy bacon.
Right.
And I am the person that sometimes you'll get the bacon on an entree like this and it's not cooked enough for me.
Mm-hmm.
You tip it, I mean, I guess there's no right or wrong answer, but I like the fact yours is a little more crisp.
Well, what I did is I cooked it in cast iron first and then cooled it, blended it with the ground beef that was seasoned and the blue cheese, and then pan seared it again, or you can do it on the grill as well.
So this is fun because you're giving your especially for a party, you're giving people different options. You're
not just
giving them one big burger, so I love that.
Right, so you can go out, like today we did, you're having the blue cheese and bacon slider.
Mm.
We also did a jalapeno popper slider with Mexican cotija cheese.
Oh, where's that?
And
here?
These little guys,
Now, same thing, you put everything, the jalapenos diced up?
Diced jalapeno in there.
All right.
Yummy. It's got a little spice to it.
And just the same ground beef you would make a burger out of?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. No, hold on.
Okay. My goodness. Didn't have any breakfast this morning, did you, Rod?
Okay. It's mild. I can taste the jalapeno.
Yeah, but it'll come on, and depending on the chilies that you use, too, of course. Now, the third one that I did, this one's a little bit sweeter. I sauteed onions in cast iron again. In a little bit of the bacon fat that I had left over.
Yeah, oh, I love that.
Are you tasting the heat now?
It does come on, yes.
Shut up, babe.
Okay.
And so you get a little sweetness. The onions, you reduce them down. They become sweet. And then I deglaze with a little bit of balsamic vinegar. So you make a little balsamic onion jam.
Okay.
Incorporate that into your ground beef. Mm. I'll have a mixing bowl, and I'll use like an ice cream scooper, and I'll just scoop them out onto a sheet pan.
So this has some sweetness to it.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay.
And then, of course,
it does, that's very flavorful. Wow.
Isn't that good?
Yeah.
Well, balsamic's one of my, you know, if I'm on a desert island, there's three things I want. Balsamic vinegar is one of them. But,
really, we got to talk.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dijon mustard, too. And an IPA. But you can have all your condiments set up on the side. People can add, you know, whatever they want to it.
This
but
is
you've
fun.
Already got a really flavorful slider ready to go.
Okay. And, and of course, you can do many things, right? You can do the pulled pork, you can do chicken, you can do whatever you want it.
Any kind of thing,
okay. And again, if you don't know, Brian will actually come into your house and give you cooking classes, or I could have you come in and more or less be the chef for my get-together, too.
Absolutely.
Is that right?
You bet. A little dinner and a show.
ChefBQ.com. We'll talk about what kind of show later. All right, coming up.